Hello, my name is Simon Stix, and in this short demonstration, I will show you one of the workflows in Tile Composer, my new code-free procedural generation tool. Right now, you can see the final results of this tutorial. There's definitely some room for improvement, but I hope I can show you how easy it is to work with Tile Composer. You can also pick up where I left off, the model will be included in the next update. I've prepared a simple tile map. Let's unpack the prefab and add a tile collection component to the root. I'll set the grid type to box and enter the size 2x2x2 like I modeled it in Blender. Next, I'll use an included helper tool to parent each object to an empty, then add a tile component to them. Now when you select the objects, you can see their grid size. To generate the result, Tile Composer has to know which tiles may neighbor each other. Let's first start with the empty tiles. Our model needs two types of empty tiles that may never touch each other. The air above buildings and empty space inside the castle and below the model. Now let's add the outside empty type to all tiles that may neighbor it by pressing its assign button, then clicking all tile sites where this type should be allowed. Repeat the same thing for the inside type. Next, we have to match tiles together. I will use the connector workflow for this. In short, each tile site with the same connector may connect to each other. I start with the simple ones. Walls can only neighbor other walls and the towers. Create the new connector, set it to bidirectional, I'll explain that one in a second. Then start the assign mode for the new connector and select the right size. Next up is the tower, there's a bottom part and a top part that can be connected. And the composite houses, which have to neighbor each other. Now we get to the more interesting part. We want the walls to neighbor anything with the same city pavement, but not each other, or they'll create thin walls of corridors. To do this, let's create a directional connector called City Floor. Directed connectors have an in and an out direction. Only in and out may be connected. Sites with the same connector direction can't be neighbors. I'll add out connectors to the walls and the castle walls. The houses and the floor sections get both in and out so they can be crammed together. Same thing with the walls and the grass, but this time let's also add the outside of the tower. Now the last thing left is the castle. I create one connector for the bottom tiles and one for the top. I'm making sure to leave out the parts inside the castle, because they will be connected to the inside empty tile. Now each tile knows which neighbors it's allowed to have, but to create the finished town we have to allow some of the tiles to rotate. I'll select all of them, then go to rotation axis and add the Y axis. To prevent some strange looking structures, I'll prevent some of the tiles from neighboring themselves by selecting them and deselecting Can Neighbor Self. The last step before generating the first model is to adjust some weights. I'll reduce the grass in the final model, increase the amount of city floors and decrease the amount of city gates. Of course, this is normally all an iterative approach with lots of experimentation. To generate the model, I'll create a new empty object and add the Tile Composer component. Here we have to select the tile collection, then we can change the grid size. If we generate the model now, we can immediately see that something is going wrong. The model doesn't have a border. I'll add a border of grass tiles around the model. You can either use the editor tools or define the area manually. If you enter -1 into one of the fields, it will wrap around, so the settings will automatically resize when you change grid size. Now let's try generating another model. That's already looking a lot better, but it's still a bit blocky. If we add the city floor connector to the tower as well, the town walls will look a lot more dynamic. Still, this whole city doesn't exactly look planned. Maybe it needs a little bit of human touch. I'll block grass on the whole model, then manually add forest grass areas in some places of the model. Now it's starting to look a little bit more like a castle. By blocking tiles in a certain area, we can create commercial areas, military areas and so on, without having to place tiles manually or worrying about how everything fits together. As last part of the video, let's look at the second constraint solver in the asset. If you switch to cell 3, you get a few more constraints to use. For example, we can say that we want exactly one city gate and over 5 small houses by creating absolute constraints. With custom properties, we could even define resident counts per tile and tell the solver that we want houses for over 100 residents. If all of this was a bit fast for you, this video was meant as a showcase. More detailed tutorials will follow, and you could comment about things you're most interested in. If you want to be notified about new tutorials as soon as I finish them, you can subscribe and click the bell icon. You could also follow me on Twitter or join my Discord, links in the description.